much. You know, in order to be a success in television, you have to appeal to everyone. From the truck driver to school teacher to the businessman. And there's one group I haven't been appealing to. In fact, not many performers have even tried to appeal to them. Dogs. Now, a lot of dogs watch TV, and there's nothing really on that they can enjoy. Maybe a couple of commercials, and that's about it. So I've worked up a comedy act for dogs. Now, I know that sounds sort of ridiculous, but I tried the act on some neighborhood dogs, and they were on the floor. With the cute little doggy laughter. So if you have a dog, call him over, let him sit in front of the TV screen, because I think you're going to see him crack up for the first time. So I'll wait just for a second while you call your dog over. Okay, now, I've invited down to the studio some dogs that I can perform to sort of get the timing down so I don't have to add any canned barks later. So here we go, my comedy act for dogs. Well, good evening, poodles and collies. Got kind of a funny story for you. You know, it was raining cats and dogs the other day. I know, because I stepped in a poodle. Well, you know what's black and white and wet all over? A newspaper. Okay, Bowser and Fido. Oh, the show's not over yet. Well, could I have a volunteer? How about you, sir? Well, where are you from? Oh, Canoga Park. Do you have a family out there, or mostly live alone? Till what time do you have to be home? Maybe he can't tell me because I have his watch. Where's the watch? I don't know. Home. Okay. Okay, put this away now, and now I'd like to. Calm down now, boys. Good dog. That's it, stay. Okay, now I'd like to play a little tune on the dog whistle. Ultra high frequency, only the dogs can hear.
Ruby, Canoga Falls tap dancing nun.
Hello, Marion. I can only stay a minute.
What brings you here, Sister Ruby?
I'm collecting to buy a going away present for Sister Elizabeth.
Oh, is she leaving the order?
Oh, no. She's been traded to a convent in Chicago. They needed a saxophone player.
Well, who did you get in return?
Sister Teresa, the juggling nun. And a first draft choice from Mother Caprini High.
Wonderful. Well, you can put me down for 10.
Thank you.
By the way, sister, this is Susie Shrimpton, and of course you know Randy Wahoo.
Hello?
Sister Ruby! You inspire me. I want to film the first underground religious musical.
Oh, it sounds interesting. What will you call it?
How about Beads Over Broadway?
Beads Over Broadway. No, On second thought, I don't want to go into films. I'm happy in what I'm doing, and besides, I don't want to.
You mean?
Kick the habit.
I do not have time for all this.
Listen, it is not fair. You have got to take her.
I'd sooner take gas.
If you don't take her off of my hands, I'm going to put her out on the streets.
Well, suit yourself. You should have put her in a retirement home a long time
ago. I have tried to do that ever since she moved in on me, but she won't budge. Listen, sister, I'm telling you something right now. It's your duty to take care of her, too. And if you don't, I'm going to take you to court. That's what I'm going to do. She is your mother, too.
I have suffered enough on that account. I don't intend to suffer for the rest of my life.
She has always hated me. She's always loved you the best. You're the one she always kissed goodnight first.
Well, she could have skipped me. I could have done without that beer breath in my face every night. And if you were dumb enough to let that dragon move in with you, then you can stew in your own juice.
Lord. Mama, now, wait, come on. You know how Ellen and me, we're always squabbling.
You stay away from me. I never expected any more from you. But you, Ellen, I have given up my entire life for you.
Oh, set it to music, Mama. Anything for anybody in your whole life. Oh, thank the Lord I left when I did, or I could have turned out like that.
Kissed him when he